Orth, Hedrick, Vice President of Product Planning. Thrilled to be with you here today to take you through the fourth generation of Sportage. We're really, really excited. I've got one of my colleagues here from Product Planning to showcase a car we're very proud of. And as Michael mentioned, we've had tremendous success since the introduction of our last model in 2010 as a 2011. And really part of our strategy for the Sportage and for all Kias going forward is strategy for growth. It's really simple. Build safe, reliable, high quality, feature packed vehicles, offer them at a great value, and ensure that our retail partners are profitable. And that strategy and formula has served us well with the Sportage and for the rest of the lineup, and so it is for the new Sportage. And as was already mentioned, we were talking about at dinner last night, design has always been a key component for Kia's success, and it continues with the new Sportage. And here, as Michael had mentioned, the vehicle was penned in Frankfurt, so if you look at all of the reference points and inspirations, a lot of it was Euro-centric, from fashion, from consumer goods, from architecture, art, and design. And you can see the European influence in the vehicle. And this is really the key point of difference. If you look at the growth in this category and the number of players who have entered into it, a lot of the vehicles started looking the same. The three big vehicles in the segment all have kind of a similar look, and we saw this as a big opportunity. And the design studio took advantage of this. And you can see that the vehicle came up very nice. From a form standpoint, it's actually wider. It's 73 inches in overall width, which is widest of any vehicle in this segment. And that really gives it a great stance and a great tumble home. So when you look at the vehicle from the rear, it looks really stable. It's got this triangular stance, and it has a very kind of stable, athletic look to it. And for us, this really is added on to the fact that the wheelbase is up about 1.2 inches. Overall length is up about 1.6 inches. And this really kind of adds to that dynamic proportions. If you look at it from the side, the overhangs are relatively short. The vehicle has a very high belt line and shoulder line, so it looks really athletic. It looks different than any other small CUV out there. And I think this is, for us, again, Kia's secret weapon, which is design, is to do something different, be more evocative, and that athleticism is also evident in the fact that the wheels, 19-inch wheels pushed out to the corners of the vehicles you're driving today. To that great form and proportion, we've added some evocative new design graphics. Specifically, this is a face that's different for us. You know, this is typically the headlights and the grille have been together on Kias as our signature face. Here, the headlights have been moved up into the upper portion and they move back into the fender line. This is a similar face that you probably saw on the Kia Niro that we introduced at the Chicago Auto Show just a few weeks ago. To that, we also added, of course, the lower wider grille, the Ice Cube LED fog lights, and also standard LED daytime running lights on every Sportage. So great iconic front end. In addition, for the models that we have with all-wheel drive, we have a mix of about 50-50 for you to drive today. Take a look at the fascias. On the all-wheel drive, you'll notice there's a different approach angle. And this is really to make the vehicle more capable in those situations where you're going through inclement weather or perhaps you're going off-road. So that's another point of difference between the front-wheel drive and all-wheel drive models. On the side, three wheels are available, a 17-inch on the LX, 18-inch on the EX, and 19-inch on the SX. My favorite view of the vehicle is this one here, around back. Wraparound LED tail lights, dual exhaust, and also a rear spoiler, a standard on every Sportage. Very sporty. It's a great looking vehicle. We're very proud of it. From an interior standpoint, there's also a great design story here. This probably was one of our biggest opportunities, was really to dramatically upgrade the interior. And here you see some of the influences, these structural, architectural details, these kind of modern, sleek, flowing lines that give you the sense of spaciousness, and that is shown in the interior. We've carried over those same kind of themes where you see these kind of pillar structures. A nice tilt, same thing that we have on the Optima. The center console has moved over about 7.3 inches towards the driver. So you have this great cockpit feel that sweeps across the interior. And it carries down into the center console with this structure on the side. So when you sit in the vehicle, it feels like it's kind of pointed towards the driver, but at the same time, it has a very premium European feel and look to it. That's the first impression you get when you swing open the door of that vehicle is really that first impression. We put a lot of effort into making sure that it has that premium feel. A few touch points on the interior that are really important are the IP itself. The IP structure is slush mold, which is relatively expensive, but it gives you a very, very premium feel. And here, instead of just doing a cap on the front, it extends all the way up to the base of the windshield. You know, a lot of manufacturers will stop it about halfway and put a cheap piece of low-molded plastic back there that usually reflects a lot in sunlight conditions. Well, here we took it all the way out to the base of the windshield. Also, padded upper door armrests, a lot of details. Here's a D-cut steering wheel with a perforated leather on the steering wheel cover. So a lot of European-influenced interiors. Also, upgraded seats. This is the same technology we used on the Sorento and also the Optima. It's a new stainless steel I-channel beam that we use for the frame, and then a lot of work went into making sure we use very high-quality bone and molding techniques. Also, a larger panoramic sunroof, so if you get a chance to take a look at it from upstairs when you're in the hospitality suite, it's a great shot. Along with the upgraded materials and design, a lot of effort went into convenience and utility. And I think for here, this is something we're also very proud about. I mentioned at the outset an increase of wheelbase about 1.2 inches, an overall length of 1.6. Well, this, the big beneficiary of this, of course, is interior roominess. Both the front legroom and headroom, and also the backseat legroom and headroom increased. The cargo area is up about 18%. Over the outgoing vehicle. And to that, we've added some really clever storage features. Of course, there's a cargo screen available, but a dual luggage floor. So if you have a taller items that you need to carry, you can move the luggage floor down to a lower space to give you a little bit more elevation. When you're sitting in the driver's seat, we've lowered both of the front mirrors down. So the sight lines out over the vehicle are much, much improved. The A pillar is thinner, mainly because of our new design structure with new materials. And also the view out the back light is much taller than it was before. Also, technology we introduced in the Sorento and also our Sedona minivan is a smart lift gate. So if you have a smart key fob in your pocket, stand behind the vehicle for a few seconds, the vehicle recognizes you're there and will automatically start opening up the door. And this is in case you have your hands full of luggage or groceries. And we think this is a better solution than other manufacturers who maybe doing a ballet out there in the back of the car trying to get the door open. So, especially for ladies if they're wearing heels, we've heard a lot of feedback that that's not really a smart thing to be doing. So if you get a chance, try that one. And then of course, with the new platform, the new body, we were able to lower the liftover height for the rear by about 2 inches.